Dave, good to see you. How did you think Jerry Seinfeld handled the pro-Palestinian protesters at his shows night after night? And then we had another protester at Tucker Carlson's Brisbane show. It seems you can't go out and enjoy yourself anymore without a protester ruining the night these days.
Well, I think Jerry Seinfeld handled those protests with his trademark humour and good sense. I think he made the point quite rightly that you're not going to solve the crisis in the Middle East by heckling a Jewish comedian from America at a performance in Australia. And I think it shows you that, I mean, some of these protesters are really, they're making fools of themselves, they're disrupting audiences, they're probably turning a whole lot of people against their message, in fact, and causing people to tune out. And I think there was polling over the weekend that shows that, you know, whilst Australians support people's right to peaceful protests in ways that do not disrupt the lives of their fellow citizens, they're becoming increasingly upset at the way some of these protests are hijacking everyday activities, whether it's university graduations, whether it's goods coming into port, whether it's people trying to do their weekend groceries.
A new study by Monash University surveyed almost 8,000 Jews in Australia 5 weeks after Hamas attacked Israel and found three quarters, or 74%, of Australian Jews had felt upset on a daily basis, and more than two-thirds of Jewish students at Australian universities had witnessed hostility from other students, and almost half had experienced hostility towards Israel from lecturers and staff. What's your reaction to those figures?
Well, they're shocking, but I'm also not surprised, Kenny. I mean, I've spoken to a number of Jewish students who confirm the results of those findings, that they're feeling unsafe on their campuses, they're sometimes feeling unwelcome in their workplaces, their businesses, older Jewish Australians who own businesses are being harassed, they're hesitant or reluctant or will not wear anything that's Jewish insignia or anything outside the house. But it's a terrible indictment on how we've handled this. I mean, this is the first time, certainly in my memory as an Australian, that I can think of a religious ethnic community in Australia being held to account, punished, ostracised, victimised as the result of a conflict happening overseas. We've historically always been very careful in Australia to, you know, whilst people are allowed to express their views on events overseas, we don't allow them to take out their vitriol or their anger against members of that community here in Australia. And that's at the heart of the compact that underlines a multicultural society such as ours. But we've completely allowed this to get out of hand. And it's really been a failure on our political leaders and law enforcement responding to their concerns that we haven't put a stop to this.
National security experts have slammed University of Sydney leadership for putting critical strategic defence research at risk in a deal between the university and its Muslim Students Association that will see defence-related research disclosed publicly online. What's your thoughts on this so-called capitulation?
I'm very concerned about it, Kenny. I mean, I think what we've seen here is a group of activists and protesters, some of whom are students, some of whom aren't, basically hijack the university's policies and interrupt or threaten academic freedom. I mean, at the heart of a university is academic freedom, and at the heart of that concept is the notion that university researchers can establish research partnerships with other countries, can collaborate with researchers from other countries. And effectively, a veto here has been handed to a group of activists, which has effectively rewarded their disruption of everyone else's studies. I mean, it sets a terrible precedent that if you want to demand a seat at the university's decision-making table, this is what you need to do. But it also imperils academic freedom, and it will hurt if Sydney University now has to give a veto to these groups and allow them to cast their eye over any research partnership. I mean, what's next? You know, where will this end? And I commend the courage of other universities who've refused to give in to these sorts of demands from protesters and said, you've got a right to protest, but you don't have a right to threaten our academic freedom, and you don't have a right to disrupt the lives of other students. I think that is the right approach to take. I mean, the university leadership is in charge here, not the protesters, and to give the impression otherwise, I think, is a deeply damaging precedent to be setting.
Yeah, Dave Sharma, we'll leave it there. Thanks so much.